Good morning. We'd like to welcome you to Coventry High School North Campus, and you're in the classroom of our teleproductions room, WCHS. We'd like to, say hi to everyone. This is the first time that we've ever tried to attempt this, and hopefully your school will enjoy this tape. I thought it would be kind of neat if we have a chance to tour our facility this morning, tell you a little bit about our program. Once again, this is not scripted. This is very informal, and we hope that you'll enjoy taking a look at our studio, and later on in the tape we're going to include some different programs that we've worked on, and we hope that your school will be able to show us some of the programs. This is our third and fourth period class. This is our first year students. Can you guys say hi?
Hi.
Boy, don't they seem energetic this morning, probably like you are early in the morning. Anyway, a little bit about our program. Our program is actually part of our Portage Lakes Career Center program. It's a vocational program, and we actually have three classes. We have a second year program with one class, and we have two first year classes this year. I think we have one class. How many kids are in our class?
Ten.
I think we have around 10 students in this class, and we have about 9 or 10 in the other first year program that takes place later this afternoon. And right now we have 5 second year students in the program. Dave is back here at the camera filming us. Can you say hi, Dave?
Hey.
Oh, there he is. There. Okay, he's saying hi to everyone. So Dave is one of our second-year students, and Dave is a senior this year. Our program basically covers, I guess I should introduce myself too, I'm sorry. My name is Chuck Lyons, I'm the director of the program. This is about our fourth year that we've actually been in production here at Coventry High School. The course itself is basically trying to cover areas of communication in regards to television production, radio broadcasting, or I actually like to refer to it as audio broadcast techniques, and also photography. We're into the beginning of our second semester. Right now we're working on photography, and aren't you guys excited about
Yeah,
if you believe that, you'll believe anything. Anyway, they take notes all the time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, lots of notes. So anyway, they're going to be very well versed in photography, hopefully at the end of the semester. So we're covering all those things right now, but we continue to do television production. Right now, everyone is standing and seated back here at our set in our studio. In a little bit we'll show you what the studio looks like. Our studio is actually just a little tiny hole in the wall. It's also our classroom. We do everything. We kind of keep locked up in this upper area, and they keep us away, I guess, from everybody else. I guess they figure we're kind of crazy, I guess. So anyway, we try to do a lot of work right out of this little room up here. In the morning we have a television announcement program. Actually, we get in here about 10 till 7, 7 o'clock in the morning. I know some of you get here even earlier. 6:30. We have somebody that get here at 6:30 in the morning, and they start getting the cameras up and running and so forth. We have to go to tape at 7:15. So really, by the time we have our on-air talent for that week get here, we pick up some of the announcements in the office that are going to be read that day. We really only have about a 15-minute period before we have to go to tape. Our school starts about 7:34 in the morning, and not only do we have to air this tape at the campus that we're at, we also have a South Campus. We're at the North Campus building, and our South Campus is located about a quarter of a mile away. Unfortunately, we do not have a fiber optic network, so we cannot send the video over the transmission line. We physically have to make a duplicate tape. We have to drive it to our South Campus to get it on the air every morning. So that's what we do every morning. We actually do a three-camera shoot of our morning announcement. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem like we have enough time to really make it a very polished professional program, and at the end of this tape you'll see some examples of some of our morning news announcements that we have. We also work on some other projects, which would be doing different promo videos, doing different commercials, and a wide variety of different taping programs around the school. We also work in conjunction with our local cable company, and last year we put on about 129 hours of programming on the cable, and this included a lot of different community events. We tape the sports programs. In fact, Matt was down last night with one of the students in our other class, and they were down taping a basketball game, and Matt was doing a play-by-play of the game. So all of those different home events, as far as sporting events go, get broadcast on our community cable station. We also have a theater that's located right beside us, and we're able to do a lot of filming of the productions that take place in our theater. And last year, I think we taped, I think there was about 29 different programs that we tape. We do a three-camera shoot, anywhere from the choir concerts to we have our grade schools come over and they put on their Christmas programs, and then we have the musicals and plays. And different events that take place, we tape them and get them on our community program. So anyway, that will tell you a little bit about our program that we have. Like I said, this is informal. I'm not sure exactly, you know, what I'm going to be telling you about, but I thought you might be interested in taking a tour of our room and our building and our facilities and a little bit about the equipment that we have. And in just a second, we're going to have everybody head to some different areas so they can show you some of the equipment that we have to work with. And like I mentioned, later we'll put on a few different programs so you can take a look at to see what we're trying to do and how they're trying to achieve to be better videographers and photographers and so forth along that line. And what do we have tomorrow in class?
Test.
I tell, what's it on?
Camera operations.
Okay, yeah, they're having a test tomorrow, and it actually will be on identification of all the different parts of a 35 millimeter camera. So anyway, we've got it on tape. You guys can't say I didn't tell you. Anyway, we're just taking a break today and trying to get this video put together to get out to your school. So why don't you just follow me, and gang, if you want to go ahead, you can head on down, and we'll kind of take you on a tour of the studio. Okay, what I hope to do now is kind of take you on a tour of our facility and show you a little bit about what our studio looks like and some of the rooms we have to work with, the equipment we have to work with, and so forth along that line. Probably one of our biggest problems that we have, we really do not have a studio. I can almost reach up and touch the ceiling. The ceiling, see? Can you see the ceiling up there? I can almost reach up and touch it. And as you know, probably from your production class, you know, most TV studios should at least be 12 feet in height. So we are very limited. We do not even have an 8-foot ceiling in here. So it makes it very, very difficult for us to try to do any work, try to do any proper lighting and so forth. But this is what we have, and we try to do the best with what we can get away with, and at least try to learn a few proper techniques. Dave, why don't you go ahead and start just a slow pan of the studio. As he is panning from left to right, you'll get an idea of the area that we have to work with. Last year we were able to build a set. This is our new set that we use for our morning television announcements program. Also, we're able to set some chairs in the same area, move our news desk, and also we can do some talk show type formats. Dave, did you get a chance to pick up some of the cameras in here? And if we take a look, we have kind of an unusual camera arrangement. These are actually Panasonic AG455 cameras that we have mounted in kind of a pseudo studio configuration. Actually, it's just on a Bogan tripod. We have a video monitor on the top of it. Actually, it's not even a monitor, it's a television set, a little AC-DC Magnavox TV that has been configured in a metal box that we had custom made that goes off and on the tripod, and the AG455, you know, is mounted at the top of it. But it does make it nice that we're able to use this, and it makes it a lot easier to do some of the production type work by, instead of looking through the camera, you can actually have the controls down in the hand, because they do have, why don't you come right around and look over here just a second, Dave, why don't you come right in on the handle and that, and you can take a look, and she has the controls for the zoom down in the handle and also has the remote off on switch so we can actually drop a videotape into the camera. Right now, when we're in the situation that we're in and working in the studio, what we're doing is we're actually taking the signals, video signals, out of the camera. We're routing those over into our control room, and we'll go down there in just a couple minutes. But we actually send the video signals from the cameras down into our control room. We also have telex headsets, so everybody can be in communication, you know, with the intercom. And we can communicate between all the video camera operators and our TD in the control room. So it's kind of a nice setup, even though it's not real professional as far as the cameras go. But it's kind of worked out real well for us, and we kind of enjoy these cameras. One of the neat things about the cameras and tripods is they can actually, you can set them up in about maybe 3 or 4 minutes. Teardown time takes about 3 minutes. You can pack them up in a couple bags and a tripod bag, and you're on the way. And in that, so we take them out to remote shoots when we're doing basketball games. But anyway, that gives you a pretty good look at our studio. This is all we have to work with. Please note, follow me right over here. And see these tables right down here? This is our classroom part of our studio that we have. What we have to do every day, usually a couple times a day, we have to go and tear down the cameras, we have to go and grab the tables, and we have to set up the tables, set up our chairs, and because we do not have desks, we have to do everything in this room. So it's rather inconvenient. I wish we had a separate room for the classroom part of our program and then had a separate studio. But once again, this is all the room we have in the building, and we try to get by the best that we possibly can. But this will give you a good idea of what we have up here, and I'll tell you what, I'm going to head on down, and I think Dave will pick us up in just a minute down in the control room. Okay, we made it to our control room, and I want to show you a little bit about the area that we're working with. Let me tell you briefly about the building that we're in. This is not a brand new building. Actually, it's kind of a very interesting story, where we're actually in a building that used to be an entertainment complex, and the entertainment complex went bankrupt, and the school eventually was able to buy the building and take this big party center and convert it into a north campus of our high school. So we're actually working in a facility that was originally used for an entertainment complex, and we've taken this particular room that is adjacent to our studio area and have made it into the control room. So Dave, why don't you spin around with me here. Like I said, once again, this is very informal. Not really sure, you know, how the lighting's going to be. We're not trying to set it or make a production out of this. Just going to take you on a video tour of everything. But this is our control room. And Eva, what are you doing?
I'm making an intro for the morning announcements.
Okay, she's making an intro for the morning announcement program. And we're working at a console area here. And then maybe, Dave, you can go ahead and tilt and pan over to some of the different equipment we have. We work with JVC decks. We actually have a record vitter, and we have two vitters for playback. And we also have a 16-channel audio board that we're able to feed the audio from Vitter A, Vitter B into, also from CD players, cassettes, and also some different microphones and so forth. Over in this area, in that, I don't know, I'd love to have Dave walk around, and hopefully he'll be able to see everything okay. Basically, our switcher is a Panasonic MX50 switcher. Actually, this is a production switcher. Not only do we use this for editing, but we also use this for doing live switching of shows. It works okay. One of the big problems that we have, though, is that we do not have a preview monitor out for that, so that is a real problem. But if you'll notice right over on the console, in that we have our three little black and white monitors that's coming from our studio upstairs for cameras 1, cameras 2, and camera 3. This way, we're able to take a look at the different cameras. Our TD will be sitting here. They'll be switching back and forth with the MX50, but they basically have to use their little black and white monitors to preview what they want to have coming up on the next bus, A or B bus. We also have a CG. We're using the Videonics Title Maker. You might have these in your studio. We actually have a couple of these, but for the price, we think Videonics is just a great unit. It's worked very, very well for us, and the CG is heavily used. Maybe Dave can catch the screen here, and you can see we have a lot of different programs in our particular CG. And every morning before we run our morning announcements during the homeroom bell, and that we go through and we have a bulletin board. And I know, Dave, that you've worked on this bulletin board. And we run this out to all the homerooms, and we have music that's playing behind it. And this goes on just before we start our morning announcement program. We do our morning announcements first at the end of the show, then we kick in to our Channel 1 program at that time. So kind of a nice area to work with. Over in our audio rack in that we have a JVC CD player, we have a Denon cassette player, we have one Sony 3/4 inch deck. We just basically use that. If anybody sends in a 3/4 inch, we can actually dupe it down to VHS. We have a waveform monitor vector scope. We were able to get that when we bought some equipment a couple years ago. Really, it doesn't do us a whole lot of good right now with the cameras that we have, but hopefully in the next couple years we can upgrade our cameras. This is our audio rack that we have. Now, Dave, we're going to spin back this way, let you walk with me, and we're going to show this area right over here. We have another rack, and you can see starting right at the top of the rack, this is the channel 1 head end unit that comes in, that goes out to the classrooms, and then below it we have the monitor, but then we also have a rack. Let me see if I can move our light around. Maybe you'll be able to see a little bit more, a little better lighting in here. We have a duplication rack we just have set up with 3 Panasonic decks that we do a lot of videotape duplication for a lot of the different sporting programs and the different concerts. We sell videotapes of the different productions in our studio that take place, also in our theater. We probably sell close to maybe 300 or 400 tapes a year of the different productions, because people are interested in their son or daughter, that if they were in this play, or if their son's playing on the basketball, has a great game, and they want to order a tape of that game. And in fact, our tapes, we sell them for $10. It's pretty reasonable, but the money goes back into our program to help pay for all the broken S cables and wires and microphones and a few little odds and ends. But instead of giving everything away, we basically sell tapes of all the different productions and so forth we have going on. So I think what we'll do now, maybe Dave, I'm just going to head on out to the outer deck. We can maybe cut it this time as I go out, and we can take you out to our area of our theater so we can show a little bit about our audio board that we have. Okay, we finally made it out to the balcony of our theater. This is just outside of our control room. We can just slip through some sliding doors and go out onto the balcony. And Dave, maybe if you want to pan, if you can pan over, I don't know if you can pick up any of the theater, you know, to get an idea of the stage area that we have. We have, like I said, this was actually not as much a theater as a big entertainment complex, but we have different stage productions that go on. We have the capability of seating about 700 people in the room, and you'll notice we have 2 large screens on either side of the stage. Those big white areas you see are actually projector screens. We have 2 video projectors that are able to project any video signal that we send to them from our control room right up onto the screens, and so it's kind of neat. Actually, during a production, we will set one camera right up here on our balcony, and then we will take our cables that we have, we'll drape them over the balcony down onto the floor, we'll bring 2 cameras down onto the floor on either side, and we can actually do a nice 3-camera shoot of the different productions that go on stage. And if we want to, we can turn our video projectors on, and we can send the signal that's coming out of our program monitor. It can actually go up onto the screens on each side of the stage. So it looks kind of neat. The people seem to enjoy it when little Jimmy is up there in the choir concert, and all of a sudden his face is about 10 feet in diameter on the screen. So it's kind of unique. There's not too many schools that have the ability to do that. Dave, if you want to follow me around, actually you can see behind me in the background, Jesse is over here working on the audio board. This is one of the parts of the program that we try to give everybody a chance to learn to use, and that's do some audio broadcast techniques. He's working with the Mackie 32 channel board that controls all the house sound for our theater. We have several microphones, a little Unipoint, Audio Technica Unipoint microphones that hang over our stage. We also have 6 wireless telex microphones that feed sound to the board. And this is a house system for the speakers in our theater. Not only for amplification, but we also take a signal from this board, we send it back to our control room, so when we're doing the video, all of our audio comes off of everything that goes through the board in the house. Very, very nice board to work with, and really enjoyed it. You'll also notice if Dave pans left, And at the monitor that you see right down here, we also have a monitor which is giving us the program signal that comes out of the control room. So we're able to take a look at what's going out on the air. A lot of times I sit out here either at this board or sit beside it, and I have a chance to take a look at the program monitor to see what's going on. All of the productions that we do, and that we try to have the students in the class do every aspect of the production itself. Somebody is going to be the TD, somebody's going to be on the audio board back in the control room. We're going to have somebody working on the audio board out in the theater area. And I'll show you in a second our computerized lighting board that we have. But we get everybody involved. Somebody is going to be the CG operator. Somebody's going to be the vitter operator. So usually it takes anywhere from 6 to 8 people to really do a show effectively. And sometimes we don't even have enough people, and we kind of have to double up on everything because you need at least 3 camera operators, and then you need 3 or 4 people up and back to try to get everything to work effectively. Once again, let me apologize for the lighting if the lighting looks kind of bizarre, because we're moving around and we do not have really good lighting in this area of the theater. So bear with us. Hopefully it'll just give you a nice little video tour of everything going on. I'm going to head on over to the other side of the balcony, and I'm going to get everything booted up to give you an idea of our console for our lights to show you what that's all about. Okay, I wanted to move to the other side of the balcony so we could show you something that we have a lot of fun working with. Once again, this is a piece of equipment that's only a couple years old, and this is our video control board. Let me try to get it right. This is our lighting board for our theater that we have, but it's a very, very nice, small, compact unit. It's a Microvision FX unit, and the nice part about it, it's all computer controlled lighting. Actually, we have 36 different channels that we can work with for our lighting in the theater, and this can all be programmed by going into the unit and punching up whichever circuit that you want to have. You can set the power if you want it at 50% power, 30% power, whatever you want. So you do have control over 36 different channels at the intensity that you want, and then you can have your fade rates in and out, and you can go ahead and you can set all of your cues into this unit ahead of time. Internally, this will store up to 200 cues, which is really nice to work with. So actually, if you're rehearsing a play, and that you can sit, you can work on your lighting cues during the rehearsals, and actually the night of the program, all you have to do is sit here with your script, and you have your cues marked in your script, and all you have to do is hit run. You don't have to work hard the night of the performances. You've done all your work ahead of time. So it's a neat little unit. Not only can you store up to 200 cues internally, you can actually save those cues to a floppy disk. So it's really neat to work with. Maybe your school has something like this, or maybe you've had it a while. This is kind of new to us, and we think it's kind of neat to work with. Okay, this covers everything that's out on our outer balcony. We're going to be heading on up through our studio area over to a couple rooms that we have for video editing and for doing audio production work.
Not actually in the tape.
Now we'll have a chance to take you over to our video editing area. We actually have to cross through our studio, but we'll go over and show you a room that we have to work with, and that where we do all of the most of the video editing anyway. Come on in with me. And if Dave can start to do a slow pan, and then he can show you some of the different equipment. We just have a small little room here that we have to work in, but we have a lot of real nice equipment to work with. We have a couple of the guys, Mike and Matt, they're actually doing some editing on the basketball game that was shot last night, and they're putting together a highlight clip. What we have, is that what you're doing, Matt?
Yeah.
I'll come in over here with you.
Yeah, I'm just taking some footage from last night's game and putting it together.
Okay. This way he can make a nice little highlight tape. Not only will we use this at the end of the year, because we have a lot of basketball players and their families that are interested in purchasing a highlight tape, but we will also go and maybe make a minute clip out of this, and we'll put it together in the morning to show kind of as an intro for our morning announcement program. Now the particular game that they're working on right now, we will go and we will take this and we'll put some credits in our intro on it. And then we will send this over to our cable company, and probably within a week to 10 days, they're going to be airing this particular game on the cable station. But this is where, at these games, we just do basically a one-camera shoot, taking one of the camera units that you had a chance to see out in the studio, taking those down to the game and just doing a one-camera shoot of the game, and usually have one or two people doing play-by-play. So it's pretty neat. The people of the community really enjoy, you know, watching a lot of the games, you know, on the TV. They're working in an area that's very similar to this. What we have back here equipment-wise, you're probably familiar with this. We have a couple 1970 Panasonic decks. We're also using the little Videonics digital mixer, which we really enjoy working with. Over at the area where Matt and Mike are, not only do we have these same units, but we also have another Videonics title maker. And also in the area that they're at, we have a CD player, we have a cassette player, we have a little audio mixing console, and they're able to do some audio dubbing, either with voiceovers or bring in music, whatever. So it makes it kind of neat to work in this area. Let me show you one other thing that we utilize a great deal of. We have a use a little Fujix copy camera for copying photographs, copying color slides, copying black and white, you know, negatives, color negatives, photographs, whatever it might be. And we really utilize it. If you can see on the screen, you can actually take any photograph. Well, we can even take wallet photographs, and we can come in and we can even crop a wallet about, I would say, half size. But it's nice for copying different photos out of magazines, taking different pictures that people have and putting together little photo montages. And a lot of the students have had projects. They've even had people hire them to make little memory montages from the photographs that they have. They'll come in and they'll copy, you know, maybe anywhere from 25 photographs. We had one young lady last year. I think she had a project that somebody gave her where there was probably 250 photographs that she copied. But they'll shoot them with the camera, and then she'll go and do some editing. She'll do some audio dubbing, put some music on, put some CG on, and make a real nice little memory tape. So it works out real well for us. We really, really use the copy camera a great deal. And it's nice we don't have to use one of the 455s or anything when we want to do copies. We can come right back in here. This little unit, if you've not seen it all, it even has its own little built-in copy stand lights. So we just put it on a copy stand, but it's nice having the little tiny lights that work. You have a manual zoom, you have a manual focus, and you do also have some color control on it. It has an automatic setting, but you can set the iris manually, and you can also you know, do some work with the color. But anyway, it's a nice little editing room, you know, that we have to work with. And I'm going to head on over and go over into our audio room. And I have no idea what they're doing. I'm walking through the studio right now, and I think everybody's took off their shoes, or somebody stole their shoes and put it in the shape of a W. And I hope this is a project that they're working on, and that I guess everybody's trying to gather up their shoes so they can go to their next grade class. Come on back with me, Dave. Let's talk to Tiffany back here. And that is this a project you're working on?
Yes, it is.
Okay, what are you doing?
I'm getting everybody's shoes and making a big W and making an intro for the announcements.
Ah, an intro for the announcements with a big W. And that's why it smells so bad in here. Is that right? Okay, anyway.
It's all his fault.
It's our cameraman's fault for doing this. No, he says no, it's not his fault. Okay, anyway, just meet me in a minute or so. I'm going to walk on over to our audio production room. Okay, here we are in our audio editing room. Once again, we have another very small room. In fact, this is even a little bit smaller than our video editing room that you just had a chance to take a look at. Right down here in front of me, Adam and Anna are working on the computer. We've just, within the past 3 or 4 months, we're finally able to get a computer up in our room, and so we're working with it. We have a program in here right now, which is kind of neat. It's made by Zettel. It's called Zettel's Video Lab. It's actually a CD-ROM program. It's an excellent software program on video production. So we're hoping to be able to utilize our computer, and we're hoping to get the internet hookup to our upper room that we have. We do have internet at the other part of our school, but we do not have any hookup upstairs right now. So we hope to get hooked up and with maybe some of the different schools that if you're online, we'll be able to communicate with you. Anyway, Dave, once you follow me, we're going to head right around. This is actually over to our audio section. What are you doing over here, Beck?
Recording some tapes.
Okay, very fine. We have a little area over here for audio production where we have a couple of CD players. We have a Tascam tape player. We also have our amplifier, have a little AM-FM tuner. And then we have a Tascam 16-channel board, and that's strictly for doing some work with microphones and turntables, cassettes, CD players, where we can mix these different audio sources together. We even have a lot of teachers that might have some old records that they want to have transferred. We've done that especially for some of the foreign language departments. They have some old records that they used in class. Well, they can't find any record players anymore. So what we have to do is we have to take the records, and we'll go over here and we'll put them on our turntable and actually be able to do some voiceovers with them, or actually transfer them to our cassette player. So it's a nice little audio room that we have, you know, to work with. And between the computer, some of the things that we're doing on the computer and some of the things we're doing in here, we're able to take these tapes and we can take them from here. Let's say if we're doing a voiceover, then we can go right down into the audio room or the television production studio, and we can use those background tapes if we need for music, voiceovers, whatever it might be along that line. One of the things we're doing right now with our computer is we're actually have our computer hooked up to our audio mixing board, and let's say if we have a music tape that we really like, but we only want 8 bars over it and we want it to loop over and over again, we can actually send it from our area right over here. We can send it over to the computer. We can go into an audio program and we can take that, let's say that 8 bars, we can loop it over and over, do whatever adjustments we want to it. We can send it from the computer back over to the audio mixer, and then we can put it back on tape. And we found this to be very useful when, excuse me, putting some things together where maybe we just wanted to have a tape loop to continuously for background music, whatever it might be. So anyway, that gives you a little bit of a look at the audio room. Now I'm going to head on out back into the studio. Well, we made it back into the studio. I'm sure that you can maybe see some activity going on behind me. Actually, it's our afternoon class right now that's working, and they're working on doing some photography. Adam, one of our second year students, came up and he's doing some portrait shots of some of our first year people, and we're going to use some of these portraits to put on a display around our room. Anyway, that will give you, I thought this was going to kind of be a brief tour of our facility and our production programs that we have. Hopefully it hasn't been too boring to you. I know I'm always interested in seeing what other people are doing, what kind of a facility they have, what kind of equipment that they have to work with. So anyway, hopefully you enjoyed that. What I'm going to do now is we're going to put on some different programs and some different promos that we've worked on. In fact, our cameraman, I want to thank Dave Morris for running camera here for me today. But some of the programs you've seen Dave has worked on, and that it will show you some things that we show on our morning program, some things that we show on the cable, some things that the students do just for fun, and always kind of, we're trying to do the best that we can with what we have to work with, and plus make this a really good learning experience for everybody. So hopefully if you enjoyed looking at our studio and our facility, I'm hoping that you'll send us tapes from your school, and that because we'd like to see what your class is doing, and for all the students out there, you know, please get busy, put some things together, put it on a videotape, send it to us so we can take a look at it. Hopefully we can all work together and you know, just keep improving our productions over and over again. So anyway, I want to thank you for taking the time you know, to be with us today. My name is Chuck Lyons, and we're at Coventry High School. We're in Akron, Ohio, and that we're about 30 miles south of Cleveland, if you're not sure where Akron is. So anyway, hopefully we'll be able to put some things together, and maybe the next time we'll take a little tour of our school so you can see what's happening in our school. So we'd like to thank you very much. I'd like to thank our cameraman, Mr. Dave Morris here, for doing this, and hopefully you'll enjoy the rest of the program. Have a good day.
Lighting serves as a key element in any video production. Good audio techniques and precise editing are just as important. These are just some of the skills you will learn as a student in the Portage Lakes Career Center's telecommunications program. Housed at the Coventry High School's North Campus, this new and innovative program will give you the basic skills in television production, radio broadcasting, and photography. You'll learn how standard lighting techniques are used in the video industry and apply these techniques to your own video productions. You will also see how microphones, sound reproduction, acoustics, audio boards and mixing, VU meters and equalization are all important elements in putting sound into your video projects. In the telecommunications program, you will learn how important post-production work is to quality video. You will implement post-production techniques in the lab by using VCRs, switchers, and character generators. You'll receive training on this sophisticated equipment and learn how to properly edit raw footage into a final product. Much of the equipment you'll use, you can find in most modern television studios today. Not only will you develop technical skills behind the camera, but you'll also have an opportunity to work in front of the camera as on-the-air talent. A daily news program, as well as a monthly news magazine, will let you become anchors and reporters and will give you the chance to practice your skills by hosting programs and reporting on topical issues. Learning all aspects of television production will better prepare you for future employment. After basic production techniques have been developed, you will work on the more advanced multi-camera shooting assignments where live productions are taped using two or three cameras. You'll learn how to produce and direct these shows, as well as learn how to operate switchers, audio consoles, and character generators. Working together as a team is an important step in video production. Hard work and dedication is expected from everyone in the telecommunications course. Besides a daily classroom schedule, you are expected to log additional hours working on video assignments outside the classroom. Shooting assignments can involve sporting events, plays, musical productions, meetings, and academic projects. Most of the school and community events taped are shown on our local community cable station, which gives the students in the program a chance to show the productions that they have created. You may also receive video experience by working in an internship program with Mark's Cablevision. This special arrangement of working with professionals will give you the opportunity to implement some of the skills you have learned in class. Mark's Cablevision tapes and airs a variety of sporting and community events. This professional experience is usually offered to college students and is a rare experience for you, the high school student. While television production is a major thrust of the telecommunications program, you will also develop a working knowledge in several communication areas, such as photography and radio broadcasting. Remember, the more you can do, the more valuable you are to prospective employers. And being part of the Coventry's North Campus, you will attend classes in math, English, science, and U.S. history. A well-rounded education combined with good technical skills are always needed in business and industry. As a graduate of this three-year program, you will have the skills necessary to obtain an entry-level job in the communications field. However, you are encouraged to continue your education at a technical school, college, or university. As a college student, the knowledge and skills you have learned through the telecommunications program should give you a tremendous advantage. So if the field of communications media sounds exciting to you, contact the Portage Lakes Career Center at 896-8200 so they can provide you with more information on this exciting program. You'll have a chance to work with the latest equipment, receive individualized attention, and graduate with a diploma and a marketable skill. Call today at 896-8200.
So tell me, Lion, how do you feel about today's adventures?
It's very interesting. You can meet a lot of little kids.
And how do you feel?
The little kids are really sweet. It's fun to see them come through here.
So how have you been enjoying this happy Halloween season?
I think this year's biggest night has been one of the most successful ever. Ha ha ha. But these foolish mortals don't seem to understand that they're never going home. Ha ha ha.
I'm curious, how much goes into this?
Well, we plan it basically after homecoming, and it's about a month long of planning, and obviously all the teachers here at Coventry were very big and instrumental in bringing in all the candy. I do want to put a plug in for Mr. Headley, whose class has donated over 4,000 pieces of candy. So together we had over 20,000 pieces of candy donated for tonight's event.
How many kids have you said, would you say, have walked in that door?
Easily over 400, probably closer to 500 tonight.
How many students do you let in? Like, is it grades 4 through 5 or?
All the elementary kids, all our three elementaries, Cottage Grove, Lakeview, and Turkey Foot, receive flyers. So we invited 1,000 kids from kindergarten through 5th grade to come here tonight.
Do you welcome strangers to Coventry, such as kids from Akron Public Schools? And
well, it's kind of hard to screen, but it's predominantly Coventry people, although obviously they might have had a few nephews and nieces and cousins come with them tonight, but it was all Coventry people who came through the doors tonight, and if anybody, it was relatives of theirs, so we welcome them. They're all part of the family.
Do you ever plan on opening up to the rest of the surrounding communities of Coventry?
If it continues to grow, we'll need a few more rooms, obviously, because of the crowd upstairs, but it would be an idea, and I would certainly be open to it.
Thank you very much. Can we see you being scary?
No, I'm Casper the Friendly Ghost, and I'm just here to be friendly. I've scared enough little kids tonight without even trying.
Hi there, CHS. Here we are in the Hudson Haunted House in the middle of the dentist scene here, one of the more scarier rooms here at the Hudson Haunted House. And this has been a great experience so far. Oh, my heart's racing. I don't...
Bart, no! All right, okay, man.
Okay, everybody, this is Bart, a staff member here at the Hudson Haunted House.
Hi, guys.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
All right, what exactly do you do here at the Hudson Haunted House?
Just that. We come out here every year in October, and we scare about 40,000 people every year.
That's cool. Well, what is your feature this year? What's new?
New this year is basically our sound system. We've gone and updated our sound system to a digital technology type sound, basically the same thing as CDs. We have stereo sound in every room. We've bought about a half dozen concert grade speakers that we use for special effects like lightning and thunder, basically subwoofers that we have in some of the rooms, really so that you can feel the scare in addition to seeing it and sometimes smelling it.
Wow. Okay,
Forget the side, Brown comes away with it. Fast break. Morning, CHS.
And today is Wednesday,
February
4th,
1998.
And
these are your morning announcements. Not news,
announcements. Hey, if you didn't come to the softball meeting last night, there are applications in the office today.
All right. The conditioning for baseball will start today. From 3 to 4 in the South Campus cafeteria. All right.
Hey, reminder to choir students, there will be pictures taken too.
Day.
During choir practice.
All right. Now the moment you've all been waiting for, drum roll everyone. All right. The McDonald's February students of the month are freshman Dana Marshall, sophomore Nick Pololi, junior Nick Husser, and senior Jesse Reedy. A representative from McDonald's will be contacting each of you to distribute your awards. Congratulations.
Jesse Reedy. All right. I hate to spoil the fun, but this is a reminder that the use of headphones at any time, including study halls, is not permitted. Also, playing cards of any type, including handmade decks, is not permitted.
Like this. Can't make this.
Like those. Can't.
Yeah.
How do we get all right. This is a policy that is listed in the student handbook, and teachers will be confiscating headsets and cards. The best policy, or the best thing to do, is just keep it at home.
All right, words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom.
Yes,
I like that.
Attention, all band members. Just a reminder, today, the symphonic band will be rehearsing after school in the theater. All symphonic band members are required to be there, and concert band members will have a rehearsal in the theater
tomorrow
after school.
It caught me.
That's okay.
You and Tony are better. You and Tony are better at this.
It happens, you know.
All right. Student council will be decorating for the sweetheart dance today and
tomorrow
after school.
Yes. All right. Now for everyone out there that has any type of piercings or whatever, jobs are really cracking down on their applicants with body piercing. To get a job even at Road Runner, you can only have a pierce in each ear.
Yeah,
So
if you have like 7 piercings,
you're out of a job. So you got to really think about it before you start marking your face up, putting your face with holes and stuff. So anyways, but that's all we have. That's the tip for today.
That's it.
All right.
Well, see you later.
We're out of here. So bye-bye, everybody. Oh, proficiency, senior proficiencies are today, and yeah, all that good stuff, yay. Okay, we're happy for it. All right, but we're out of here. Ever been when I grew up with my best friend Kenny, we were closest any brothers that you ever knew. It was always summer and the future called. We were ready for adventures and we wanted them all. There was so much left to dream and so much time to me.
Bernardo was right. One of you were lying in the street bleeding, I'd walk by and spit on you.
Don't let her go!
Let go! I've got a message for your American buddy. Tell the murderer Marie's never gonna meet him. Tell him Chino found out and shot her.
What?
does it take to get through to you? When do you stop? You make this world lousy.
That's the way we found it, Doc.
Get out of here!
How it is, huh?
Quiet.
Come down.
No.
Maria.
Please, if Bernardo came
He's
home and
found... Come down.
He will soon bring Anita home.
Just for a minute.
A minute is not enough.
For an hour, then.
I cannot.
Forever!
Shh.
Then I'm coming up.
It is dangerous.
I'm not one of them.
You are. But to me, you are not. Just as I am one of them.
To me, you are.
Marupa!
Si vengo, Papa!
Maruka?
His pet name for me.
I like him, and he will like me.
No, he is like Bernardo, afraid. Imagine being afraid of you.
You see?
I see you.
See only me. Every sight that I see is Maria.
Tony, Tony.
Always you, every thought I'll ever know. Everywhere I go, you'll be.
The world is on me.
That's what they are, yes? Or whether or not to cut off somebody's head. She would take away this stuff.
Fiddlesticks.
Well, I'll take a bottle of that, Mr. Padlock.
Precious stuff.
How much?
2 bits.
Throwing away your money.
Helps you decide what to do.
All right, now, Aunt Della, don't you want me to show you some tricky doodads with girls running in and out?
You mean fancy drawers?
Straight from Paris.
Well, I don't usually like to wear that kind of stuff, but sure do like to look at them.
Oh, yes.
It's all right if you ain't going no place.
Well, bring your trappings inside. Maybe I can find you something to eat.
Well, ask him why don't you. Allie Hackum.
Yes, baby.
Me and Lori's been having an argument.
About what?
About what you meant when you said that about driving with me to the end of the world.
Oh, I didn't really mean to the end of the world.
Well, how far do you want to go?
Oh, say as far as Katusi.
To the hotel.
What's at the hotel?
Well, in front of the hotel is a veranda. Inside a lobby. Upstairs for you and me, baby. Paradise.
I thought they was just bedrooms.
Oh, no, for you and me, baby. Paradise.
Three, two straight possessions. Trying to make up for that bad judgment. Matt Gerstenslager trying to find something. Takes it himself up the hole and in. Matt Gerstenslager's been doing that forever. They can't stop him. Tim Brown yet to shoot a three. But they're playing a little bit of different game plan. I believe in the fourth quarter they'll probably go back to it. Just gonna get Western Reserve thinking they're not gonna do it. Taking it all the way to the hole. Nice move by number 33, Josh Humphrey. Matt Gerstenslager bringing it up the court slow. Giving him some time to rest. Out to Tim Brown, little pick there. Nice steal by Keel. Keel taking it up over to Humphrey. Humphrey looking around, taking it himself. Oh, and he draws the foul. Went up strong. Nice move there by Josh Humphrey.
Caroling, caroling, now we go. Christmas bells are ringing. Caroling, caroling through the snow. Christmas bells are ringing. Joyous voices, sweet and clear. Sing the sad of heart to cheer. Ding dong, ding dong. Christmas bells are ringing. Caroling, caroling through the town. Christmas bells are ringing. Caroling, caroling up and down. Christmas bells are ringing. Mark ye well the song we sing. Glad some tidings now we bring. Ding dong, ding dong. Christmas bells are ringing. Caroling, caroling near and far. Christmas bells are ringing. Following, following yonder star. Christmas bells are ringing. Sing we all this happy morn. Mother, King of heaven is born. Ding dong, ding dong. Christmas bells are ringing.
Thank you.
Today's workforce is constantly changing. Today, some form of technology is utilized in almost every job. At Portage Lakes Career Center Springfield campus, we're using technology to teach career skills that will last a lifetime. Whether it's using a computer to type business correspondence in the computerized office systems program, designing a brochure on the computer in the graphic arts program, or machining metal on the CNC lathe in the machine technology program, students enrolled in programs at the Springfield site are being trained to enter the job market of the 21st century. That job market requires more than just a high school diploma, but less than a four-year degree. In fact, according to the Ohio Department of Education, 80% of the jobs in the year 2000 and beyond will not require a four-year college degree, but will require a technical training, the type of training that they receive at the Portage Lakes Career Center. At Springfield High School, approximately 60% of the juniors and seniors are enrolled in one of the Career Center's eight programs housed there. Those students receive individualized attention, learn to work in labs that focus on hands-on training, and graduate with a diploma and a marketable skill. Students who meet attendance and grade requirements also receive a career passport to show employers the competencies they've acquired through their vocational training. Portage Lakes Career Center and its Springfield campus offer programs that fit the changing needs of business and industry. Through partnerships with area businesses, Springfield's vocational programs match job training with performance skills necessary for successful employees. The courses and equipment are constantly monitored to ensure that students remain competitive in the job market. The School to Work programs at the Career Center Springfield campus give students valuable experience in training for their careers. One of those careers is a computerized accounting program. This program gives students an opportunity to learn and practice a variety of business and office skills, which lead to employment in the expanding and highly technical office job force.
In first place, with an average of 4.000, Kevin Duff. Students in the class of 96.
To Mrs. Thomas and the Board of Education, we would like to begin the presentation of diplomas for this year's 1996 graduating class. Ryan P. Bailey. Sarah Bogman.
Robert Beck. Todd J. Belcher. Bethany Rebecca Benedict. Katie Bennett. Michael J. Bennett.
Oh!